All right, YouTube. How is everybody today? I've just wasted the last 20 to 30 minutes fiddling with my mic because I already recorded this video and now I have to start from scratch because the mic kept cutting in and out on me. So anyways, let's start again. Huzzah! Now, as somebody with about 6,000 plus hours of somewhat AFK farming on Chronicles, I have come to the conclusion after seeing what I feel the future for the game looks to be, that I simply do not have the time for Chronicles anymore, either now or in the future. Mostly because of the... how do I phrase this? The infinite black hole of never being able to achieve an end goal, I suppose. So, for example, the summoners, for example, you hit level 70, hit level 70 on all three of them. Now there's a level 80, you got to hit level 80 on all three of them. Korea's already got that update. Same for thing for your monsters. Let's say you build like 40 plus level 70 monsters, and now you've got 40 plus level 80 monsters to build. And it's just this, you know, the daily logins, right? Chronicles is this game that has a lot of content, right? And a lot of content is great. However, what I feel isn't great is that there's a lot of required content as well. So, like, the daily logins for support stuff, the weekly login stuff, the... you know, the monthly login stuff, just there's this consistent go be on multiple times a day, every day kind of thing going on. The field events, for example, you have to be on at certain times of the day. There's a lot to keep track of in Chronicles, and I feel that Chronicles kind of suffers from a similar problem that Lost Ark suffered from, where there's a lot of content to do, but there's a lot of required content to do as well. And unfortunately, I feel like, unlike Lost Ark, which, while a lot of Lost Ark, for example, had a lot of kind of stuff that you kind of felt like you had to do if you wanted to maintain your progress or to continue progressing in the game in general, it also had tons more stuff that wasn't required for a daily login requirement. Whereas Chronicles kind of, the way that Chronicles went is that it has mostly daily login requirement stuff, because I guess it's more of a mobile game than Lost Ark was, for example. And while I do enjoy the whole fact that Chronicles, I feel like, is essentially just this Pokemon, it's what a Pokemon MMORPG would be, if it was kind of action-based instead of turn-based, right? That's what I kind of approach Chronicles as. However, with the time constraints, for me personally, I don't have time for this game anymore. I kind of ran into the same issue with Lost Ark back in the day, but Chronicles is one that's taken... it's just taken a lot longer to reach that point for me because I was enjoying it so much, right? I still had my kind of rose-tinted glasses on to an extent. I've never really liked the PvP in the game. I feel like there's a lot of issues both with the battlefields, the brawl system, the arena system, the AI, the way the AI works, the way that the sync skill often either doesn't go off or it goes off on a delay, or you'll literally not CC'd and it just won't use it. You have to like spam the skill and it's not a lag thing, you're not crowd controlled, it just doesn't work. Or it does use it and it uses it on the wrong unit, for example. I feel like, for example, for Brawl, it's like, well, listen, if you want the AI to do the fighting instead of me controlling who I want to attack, then just don't even have us manual it to begin with, all right? Just make it like normal arena so you can just auto the whole thing, whatever. But anyways, getting off topic, Chronicles itself, there's a lot of flaws and stuff that I feel like are in the game. Excuse me. However, I don't want to make this like a big negative video. This is literally just going to be a video of more so that there is just so much time being taken up by Chronicles. I don't have time for other things. I've got a lot of kind of more real world obligations that I need to keep up with lately. And I have some other projects kind of in the works that I want to kind of work on. I have other games that I want to play and enjoy. And Chronicles takes up this absolutely massive chunk of my day, every day, while I'm doing other things. So, like, I can't even really, like, a lot of the reason I haven't been streaming is because I got the little one, she's quite loud and stuff, and don't want to scream into the mic, right? However, when I'm playing Chronicles, I'm also trying to keep up with my other games, like Nikki, and I've been playing Star Rail lately. And I have to open them while playing Chronicles, because Chronicles is this never-ending pit, this never-ending black hole of I have to constantly be doing things on it every day, all day, in order to, say, kind of keep up, or just to progress in general. And every day I kind of feel like burned out just doing the dailies, and then I don't feel like progressing anymore. And I feel like with the amount of time that I put into Chronicles, it's just kind of a mixture of takes up too much time, the game's gotten quite stale for me, I'm suffering from burnout for it, and I can't really put out instructional videos when I'm feeling burned out on a game. Feel like obviously I would, you know, especially when the videos these days are like, everyone kind of understands it anyway now. There's not much other than starting to dive into the individual units where they can be used for PvP and PvE and doing deep dives on those units, and I'm not really feeling it, if that makes sense, because of the burnout, because of the dailies, the time constraints and stuff. So this is essentially a video of I am planning to move on, go back to other things, like generally like I was saying before, because I have these other games up while I'm trying to do Chronicles, I don't have the system resources on my computer to both also stream. Plus, so there's like this mixture of I can't run 2 to 3 games at a time while streaming with a little one in the background screaming into the mic, right? So I do plan on kind of going back to chilling on streams and staying away from triggering things like the PvP and Chronicles. I do enjoy the PvE still. I think the PvE is great. I like the way that they set up the quest system so that you can kind of auto your way through the quests, of course. If you don't want to bother manually through them and all that kind of stuff, you can leave that part out, skip ahead to the end game raids and dungeons and stuff. There's a, like, again, there's a lot to do in Chronicles, and it's great, I feel like. You know, but I personally just don't have that kind of time, and I don't feel like putting that kind of time in for this one particular game anymore either. Now, that doesn't mean necessarily that all content on Chronicles is going to just completely stop, because I have part of the kind of projects that I'm thinking of for future stuff to play around with, because like, YouTube is kind of just this is like a side hobby kind of thing I do for fun on the side, and if I'm not having fun, then there's not much point in me trying to force anything to fit into some kind of specific or particular niche, if that makes sense, right? So for me to continue having fun, I have some other ideas on what I want to kind of do. I've been looking into some of this AI stuff lately, and it's looking pretty fun. So I am planning on essentially trying out some stuff, and I may upload some of the experimental stuff to this particular channel, and it may involve some Chronicles stuff. Maybe I'll keep up with the updates a little bit still for some time, for the time being as well, but in the meantime I'm probably just gonna go back to chilling out with demos on stream, or other games, right? Like just catch up on my backlog, for example, and just, you know, yeet them onto the YouTubes, right? I actually have some old PlayStation games I want to play through and upload the my playthrough on those, for example, but you know, this is all kind of unrelated to the topic at hand. At the end of the day, I feel like Chronicles, it suffers a lot, and from the amount of time that it does take up each day. And while I know that there are people that do enjoy deep diving into one specific game at a time, and maybe they'll just play only that game all the time for months, years on end, I do think that there's this like inconsistency when it comes to a free-to-play trying to build something and never being able to finish building it. This includes gear, equipping gems to gear, grind, like, you know, essentially grindstones and stuff. There's, when I look at like the correlation between Sky Arena and Chronicles and the way that Comtuos have been handling their games and such, there's just, I don't see an endpoint, and it feels bad when you think you've finished building a unit or a summoner and then they will drop more stuff, that instead of just dropping the whole game at once, they are slowly dropping this, you know, constant new content where you're gonna have to just keep upgrading things for all these units. And I for one am not feeling it after these after playing previous games that do this kind of stuff, regular MMORPGs and things like that, where it's just this never ending, oh, there's another 10 levels, oh, here's some, you know, new gear, throw that on your unit. For a game that's going to have like 300 plus units, I cannot do that again. It's like if I've just finished building 30 units, you got Siege Battle, and all this other time consuming stuff, where you're going to need multiple teams, multiple units and things like that. Battlefield, regular arena PvP, Brawl, etc. You know, the other day I did my Brawls and I did 20 entries and it took like an hour and a half to get through them. And that was before I even hit up the PvE content, right? The daily PvE stuff. So it's like, with all this kind of stuff, and you collect all these resources by being kind of forced to do your daily stuff to get the resources to hopefully finish progressing a unit or a summoner, and then they just kind of move the goalposts again, and you're like, well, what did I do that for? Now I have to go back, fix up all these units that are now broken essentially because they're unfinished and I can't use them in the new content anymore. I have to go back and rebuild them, and then go back onto the units that I was now working on because I thought I was finished with the last ones. That's just not for me, right? That lifestyle in a video game, it's just not for me anymore these days. I know a lot of people are going to enjoy that, but for me, it's just, I don't have the time. I just don't have the time for that stuff, right? So I need to kind of move back to more kind of drop-in, drop-out kind of games for me these days. I'm probably still going to jump into some gachas and stuff, check them out. Like, again, I'm still playing Nikki and Star Rail, for example, because they are easily drop-in, drop-out kind of games. Until Nikki Union raids, they can get a little sweaty and take a little time. Excuse me. But yeah, I just wanted to kind of address those kind of things and say, I do think that Chronicles has a lot of really good points going for it. The active player base on Global and by the look of it, also Korea is really good. Feel a bit bad about how NA's kind of, there's not many people playing these days. Like, it is very, there's a long queue times and things like that. So they are kind of getting a much worse experience. So hopefully something can be done about that. Maybe cross server stuff or something like that, perhaps cross region. I mean, regardless of lag or not, maybe people can opt in, opt out. I don't know. Hopefully they get it sorted, and hopefully I am hoping that Comtuos find a balance between the, it's great to have a lot to do in a game, it's not so great to have a lot of required things to do in a game, and I feel that's where Chronicles really suffers, with having so many things to kind of upkeep with and keep track of, like, you know, the, again, trying to remember field events, hero area maps, which raids and raptures you know, which raids and stuff that you have yet to do for the day, your expedition each day, your farm, you know, your Kairos and Path of Growth and yada yada, whatever it is that you're farming, right? Each day, trying to keep up with that. Are you going to refresh them and do more? You know, there's just way too many things to keep track of, I feel. And for I, for one, with the burnout and all that kind of jazz, it's just, I need that time for other things. That makes sense. So I have uninstalled the game. If you haven't figured out, just, you know, by the picture that I have up instead of the game running, I have gone and done that now. And we'll have to see how things go with the future stuff, because I am kind of, you know, I got some new interests to look into, and I'll still be around keeping track of Chronicles and stuff, because I do, you know, I'm keen to see how they evolve it over time. But right now, I feel like the state that it's in, it suffers a lot from what happened with Lost Ark. And as people can see, that game lost a lot of its player base, mostly because of the bots, but also because of the just complete burnout. There was just so much required stuff to do, and I feel like Chronicles does that, but like 2 to 3 times more. Because it's just very inconsistent with the amount of things that you have to do each day, versus just, you know, people want to kind of log in, have fun, and log off. They don't want to have a second job or a third job or a fourth. And Chronicles is kind of like two jobs in one. It's like having two side jobs in one to kind of keep up with what it's asking for as far as trying to progress goes. Because just doing the daily requirements, by the time you're done with those, you just don't even feel like trying to work on anything to progress anymore. It's just total, it's just like you want to go do something else at that point, or you have to go do something else, really. But like I was saying before, second time I recorded this, I feel like I've missed something. The video is already 3 minutes longer than it was before, but I've definitely forgotten something from what I mentioned in the last video that I failed to record. But this time around, I do just want to mention once again that this isn't kind of the end of me looking at Chronicles kind of stuff, but also I'm probably going to be approaching it in a different way, because I have some ideas on what I want to do with this YouTube channel that, again, is just kind of a side hobby, and I want to have fun with it. And, you know, I think I mentioned it just before in this video, but kind of been looking at some AI kind of stuff and thinking maybe some parody stuff, throw up some experimental stuff here, and then just stick with other games and things like that. You know, taking animated stuff, making it real, taking real stuff, making it animated. I don't know, some storyline based stuff. I don't know. It's just kind of piqued my interest these days, and it looks fun to kind of work on and do. And maybe I'll throw up some of my experiments on the channel, but other than that, you know, see how they go. And but other than that, I'm just gonna be back to basics of throwing my highlights up, I feel like, because Chronicles really killed my stream time, not including, like, obviously, again, baby noises in the background, but just it hasn't been hitting me lately, and it's not really a game that I feel like streaming either, because it just, even if I could, because it just is so auto, you know, all the auto farming and stuff like that. I kind of want a more active game, maybe jump in and jump out with people in the chat and play around with them and stuff like that. Kind of game is more my preference these days. Anyways, I'm gonna cut it there, guys. I hope that kind of gives a bit of an explanation. I'm not trying to like shit on the game or anything, because again, I think it has a lot of positives, you know. Again, I feel like there's a great combination between the I feel like they've done a really good job at balancing the mobile to PC kind of aspect on how complicated the game is, and versus how accessible it is as well, as far as a mobile and PC combination game go. and I'd be keen to see more games like this in the future where it's, you know, you've got your minions and stuff following you around and you tell them what to do and things like that. I love that kind of I love those kind of games. I love playing like a summoner or anything like that. Yeah, that's kind of my jam for a lot of games, and it's a big thing. Like, it's one of the big attractions that I had towards Chronicles too. It's just, you know, it gets really bothersome when you try to tell things to do something and they don't do it. Even in like White Shadow Castle, the first 10 to 20 seconds, I still have one or two units just standing around doing nothing a lot of the time. So really unfortunate, because you know, you want to get that early 70% drop on the White Shadow Castle boss, and it just, you can't do it because two of your units are out of commission. They're just standing there. But anyways, gonna cut it there, guys. I will catch you later on the next one, I hope. Peace.